Wait. See, I know this may sound unbelievable, but what if I told you that instead of having to spend 5 to 7 hours on one church flyer design, that you could actually get this design finished from scratch to finish in less than 1 hour? Sounds unbelievable, right?
When I want to explain it, my head will be headache me.
But that's what I thought until I tried it out and it actually worked. See, by the end of this video, you should be able to design a church flyer from start to finish under an hour using any tool of your choice. It could be Pixellab, it could be Canva, it could be Photoshop, it could be Coreldraw. Your software doesn't matter in this case. All you need to know is just two very simple things, which I'll be showing you in the course of this video. So go ahead, hit the subscribe button if you're new to this channel. And if you're a returning subscriber, please don't forget to like this video and leave a comment. I'm very sure you'll find it helpful. So go ahead, leave a comment and tell me how helpful you found this video to be and what other videos you'd love to see me make on the subjects of graphic design and video editing. Go ahead and let me know. With that being said, my name is Onyedika Israel. Welcome to the Portal of Value. Let's dive right in. Now, all you need to do is very simple. The first thing you need is a very popular app, actually. It's called, drum rolls please, Pinterest. Now, I know many of you know this app. Many of you use it for many things. You have the app already on your phone. If you're a graphic designer, you will agree with me that one of the major things that actually take your time when you're designing is your backgrounds, the backgrounds of the designs, especially church flyers. Backgrounds can be really intricate and time consuming. But did you know that on Pinterest you can find already made designs? Now, a little disclaimer, I don't advise and I don't recommend that you follow this method every time. You know, I understand that there are times when we can be choked up and we need just a quick fix, but don't make this a habit because it will kill your creativity. Okay, that being said, let's go ahead. So now you go on Pinterest, you'll find already made backgrounds, church flyers, several of them. And all you really need to do is to refine your key phrase. So let's say you need to do a church flyer for the team, the appointed time, or for a crossover service. Just type crossover service church flyer background. And then you can even go ahead to refine the search to include the color of the background you want. So you can add red crossover flyer church flyer background, or blue church flyer background, or green church flyer background, or white church flyer background, or anything. You can just refine the search phrases. Okay, that is the first thing you need to do, and that is step one. Now moving on to step two. Step two is that you need to have a firm grasp of the principles of design. Yes, principles such as contrast, alignment, emphasis, every of those things. You also need to understand typography and font pairing and font usage. After you downloaded your background from Pinterest, just bring it into your editing software. It could be Pixellab, like I mentioned, anything at all. Just bring it in, and then you want to start putting your text directly on top of the background. Now, a pro tip, pay attention. You may decide, like me, not to just dump the background straight into your design and use it like that. You can decide to touch it just a little. In a few minutes, you are done touching this up. Maybe reduce the brightness, increase the contrast. You can do that in any photo editing software, even your device's photo editing software. Yes, you can do that there. And just touch it up a little bit and then bring it in. Okay, now having done that, you can start putting in the information, the details of your design, like the topic, the name of the church, the theme, the date, and you can spice it up by putting maybe blood icons or lens flares or light flares around the design, or some other effects like a noise effect or like a vignette, just any other effect to make it creative. And then you can go ahead and even use text effects. And I tell you the truth, between the time where you went on Pinterest to search for your background and this point where we are now, 1 hour surely would not have passed. In fact, you can be done with this in 30 to 45 minutes if you're fast enough. See, nothing is new on the face of the earth. Yes, nothing is really new. Creativity is all about you refining or redefining what already exists and making it to be your own, owning it. And this is just one aspect of it. But like I said, please do not make this a habit. It's going to kill your creativity. You can actually create your own backgrounds from scratch. But just in case you are in a fix and time is a factor, I mean, why not? Thank you for sticking through to this point in the video. Please subscribe and also like this video. Leave me a comment down below Tell me what country you're watching from. Tell me if you found this video exciting. Tell me if you found this video helpful. Go ahead and let me know. I'm on a 30-day streak and this was day 4 of 30. Which other video should I create next? Graphic design, video editing, any topic, just let me know. I'll be reading the comments and I'll definitely create a video about that. And if you enjoyed this particular video, I'm very, very sure that you'll enjoy many, many more videos like this. There are lots of them on my channel. Go ahead, you can click this one right here or this one. There should actually be a video attached here. Just in case it's not attached, I'll link a couple of videos in the description. That being said, I'll see you guys in the next one. Please subscribe. Subscribe. You've not subscribed. You've not subscribed. Please subscribe.